this video is about Bowdoin's housing lottery process. The lottery process prioritizes seniors, then juniors, and then sophomores. In addition to this video, you should read the material on the housing lottery website. That's where we explain the process in more detail, provide deadlines, lottery dates, and more. You can also learn about each location and view general floor plans and layouts. Log in to Bricks and Beyond by going to housing.bowdoin.edu. Select Fall Housing Lottery and confirm the term. The first thing you need to do is complete a mandatory profile. These are just a few questions that give information about your living habits to your potential roommates and allow anyone looking for a roommate to search on specific criteria. Even if you are a group of one looking for a single room, you must complete the mandatory profile. You can choose whether or not your responses will be searchable. Once you complete and save your mandatory profile, you'll move into the section for roommate groups. Even if your goal is to select a single, you still need to create a roommate group. Roommate groups can have between 1 and 8 people, but space is limited for larger groups. If you have a larger group, you must plan ahead for how you might split into smaller groups if necessary. Let's meet Abby, Bailey, Cole, and Drew. They've decided to form a group of 4, with Cole as the group leader. Why Cole? Because he has great Wi-Fi, and he's committed to being at his computer during their designated time slot. Who shouldn't be your group leader? Anyone who might be unavailable or have difficulty connecting. Your group should plan a way to stay in touch during the process so that you can make decisions and adjustments if your top choices aren't available. If you can't be together in person, you can plan on a Zoom, a group text, a 1980s landline phone, or a walkie-talkie, whatever works to make sure that you can get a hold of each other. Because he's been chosen as the group leader, Cole will create the roommate group. Group names are seen by staff and the community, so please keep them PG. After creating the group, he can search for Abby, Bailey, and Drew, and send them requests to join his group. Each of them will see the request and be able to accept or reject it. The group is coming together. Abby and Drew have accepted, but Bailey hasn't approved Cole's request yet. Group leaders can view all members and reassign the leader role if needed. Remember, your group leader has the authority to select your housing for next year, and you are bound by their choice. The lottery will consist of 3 rounds. All available rooms will be included in every round. The first round is only for seniors and will be open for multiple days. All senior-only roommate groups, regardless of size, will have the option to select in round 1. Students can confirm their points by checking their class standing in Polaris. Your roommate group will be eligible for the lottery round of the lowest point of anyone in your group. For example, if there are 2 seniors and 2 juniors in a roommate group, they will not be eligible to select until round 2. Their group's point average will be 2.5, so they will likely have a time slot near the beginning of round 2, ahead of the all-junior groups. When your lottery round opens, you can move to room selection. This screen will only show you the available buildings that match your group size. In our example, that's a group of 4. Based on their previous conversations, Cole selects Harpswell Apartments. This screen shows all of the available beds in Harpswell Apartments. Note that there are several pages of results, because this shows beds and not units. You'll see that there are 4 slots labeled 1A, because there are 4 beds in 1A. You only need to choose one of them. If other roommate groups have confirmed their housing on this same floor, you'll be able to see their names in the preview of floormates. The group leader will now assign a bed to each roommate. Save, and continue to confirmation. Make sure everything looks correct, and then you must enter your Bowdoin ID number and click Confirm My Housing for your reservation to be complete. If your first choice isn't available, you have the following options. You can remove students from your group to get to your desired group size. You can add students to your group. You can merge with another roommate group. Or you can delete the group entirely and everyone starts over to form new groups with sizes that work with the remaining rooms. It is very important to have a plan B and a plan C for housing ahead of time, so you don't get flustered if your first choice is not available. There are designated rooms and buildings set aside as substance-free housing, which means no alcohol consumption or substance use of any kind. If you select one of these options, you will confirm online that you agree to these policies. The tips to a successful housing lottery? Read the details and dates online. Talk to your friends. Make sure everyone knows their lottery points and preferences. Have backup plans ready, including different buildings and different group structures. We can't wait to see you in the fall.